On Twitter, a lot of the little Twitter trolls, they like to say, oh, Jesus didn't need an AR-15. How many AR-15s do you think Jesus would have had? Well, he didn't have enough to keep his government from killing him. So...
Second biggest issue with that is that she thought that that was going to be a killer line. And the audience was like, I'm going to say confused, perhaps uncomfortable. Like people have pointed out a great point that you like profess to follow the divine word of Jesus, and he's supposed to be your personal savior, the model for your life. And no, he would not have been running around with guns and posing and photos of guns. These are great points that the Twitter trolls are pointing out. Also, I love that she's criticizing Twitter trolls when she is literally, even when not on Twitter, she's just a Twitter troll. That's all she is in real life. That's why she's elected, and she knows that that's her appeal. The bigger issue though, JR, is the scriptural issue. And granted, I'm a big old atheist and everything, but even I get that. I don't think that's the lesson of the death of Jesus Christ, JR. I don't know. Did you ever, were you a church going man?
I
feel like he wouldn't have gunned down everyone to save his life.
Yeah, it's been a while since I've been there, so maybe a little rusty. But the entire basis of Christianity, like, you know, this version of what happened with Jesus, the reasons why you celebrate Easter actually should be the biggest holiday of the Christian faith, because it's the reason why we even have a chance at life. You know, we're down here on this earth and we all just suck. And the thing is the only way to get to that divine divinity and sit next to Jesus is to believe in his sacrifice. That was the sacrifice in giving his life. And when he was killed by the state and he lost his AR-15 and wasn't able to murder everyone in his wake, he sacrificed himself for us. Did you get that part when you were going to church, Lauren? Again, maybe I'm a little rusty on this, but that's the whole basis for it, is we accept that because he did it for us. That's why we love him so much, because he loved us, right? Right, but she doesn't have that. All she has is jokes about how AR-15 is actually the thing that you worship and not Jesus.
100%. And that is more authentically, that is her religion, honestly. I get that the Bible is long or whatever. I've never read the entire Bible, and apparently I have that in common with Lauren Boebert. I also don't profess to be a good Christian and have some sort of natural state of moral superiority over the entire world, which she definitely thinks that she has, seemingly having missed. Like, at least for modern Christians, it's not just that she missed a point about Christianity. The thing about his sacrifice, isn't that the single most important part of all of Christianity? And she doesn't get it. And she doesn't know the scripture. Like, a lot of people pointed out this from Luke, when Jesus's followers saw what was going to happen when he was going to be arrested, they said, Lord, should we strike with our swords? And one of them struck the servant of the high priest, cutting off his right ear. But Jesus answered, no more of this. And he touched the man's ear and healed him. He literally didn't want them to use their weapons. That seems pretty obvious. He was the turn the other cheek guy, you dunce. How do you not get this? He wasn't a fan of violence. And more importantly, like, she thinks she's making this amazing point that he should have had more weapons so he could defend himself from his government. What she doesn't seem to realize is that the scenario that she's sketching out is a religious fundamentalist government that is going around and persecuting social justice warriors. That is what actually happened with Jesus. How are you not getting this? You don't get the Christianity, you don't get the history. What part of this do you actually understand?
The parts you can use to gain power and money.
Yeah, if not draw much laughter.
Yeah.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.